Hey everyone, this is a video series intended for developers that want to create Flipper Zero applications. This series is going to cover using scenes and reusable components so that you don't have to create everything from scratch. Okay, let's get started. In this video, we're going to look at the Flipper Zero running code using a scene manager. I'll put a link in the description to the GitHub tutorial that I've created. Next, we'll talk about the advantages and disadvantages of using the scene manager. And then we'll talk briefly about the next video and the series. I'll also be releasing other videos unrelated to this series. So if coding isn't your thing, hopefully my channel will still provide lots of value to you. If you have any questions or comments, I really appreciate putting them below. All right, so I've got my Flipper Zero up. We're going to go into the scenes demo. Again, this is on my GitHub tutorials. And what you see here is the first scene, which is called the volume scene. And if I press the down button, the numbers go increasing. And if I press this, the numbers decrease. This volume scene is using a custom knob control, which we're not going to talk about for a few videos. So if I press OK, we switch to the frequency scene, and the frequency scene is also using that same component. And then I'm going to press OK again. And now we're in the summary scene, and the summary scene is using a different component. This is the widget component. And as I press up and down, we're scrolling this text scroll. And then when I press OK, we go back to the volume scene. So if I hit the back button, we back up one scene to our summary scene. If I hit the back button again, we're at the frequency scene. The back button again, we're at the volume scene. The back button again, and we've walked through all those scenes. So now the application exits. Okay, so to review, we first had a scene called app scene set volume, and then we had a scene called app scene set frequency. And then we had a scene called app scene summary. And those first two scenes were using one component, and this third scene used a different component. So our application was using a scene manager, and it has some advantages. One of the advantages is complex navigation. So as you're going from one scene to another, all that's a lot easier because you basically just tell the scene manager, I want to transition to this scene, or I want to go back to the previous scene. And you don't have to have all that kind of logic keeping track of all the scenes you've been to. And then reuse of components is also a big advantage. So there's all these different components that are built in, and you can do things like a file browser or text box or submenus and even widgets to kind of build a composite UI. And so you don't have to write all that code from scratch. So I think that's a pretty big advantage. The disadvantage is for a simple application, it is overkill and you should probably just use Viewport where you're just doing your draw and your input events. So if you're writing a snake app, you're not going to get any advantage to having a scene manager for everything. But if you're going to have the high scores and all that kind of information, then probably it's good to add a scene manager. Also, there's not a lot of documentation or tutorials on the scene manager. Because there's not a lot of documentation, I'm actually not sure what some of these things are called. So I'm calling the reusable components components. Maybe they're called view modules, or maybe there's something else. I don't know. But when I say component, I'm talking about either a widget or a file browser or a text box or pop-up or any of those kind of things. It's something that contains a view. We'll get into more details on what a component is later. But I apologize if I'm using the wrong terminology. I hope you found this overview helpful. In the next talk in this series, we're going to talk about application concepts, like the data, the components, the view dispatcher, and the scene manager. And then we'll look at the code that implements some of that concepts that we've discussed. And then we will talk about the video after that as well. So I'm trying to keep these videos fairly short, kind of the 5 to 10 minute range. and I'll try to release them about weekly. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.